in, well, now watch has become sort of my studio. It's been about 6 months now. We've been sort of treating it like a studio. And even though the studio is right in front of me, we're sort of like scared. Should we go back to being normal as it was? Probably will happen soon. But you know, at least some films have started to come out. It's been a tough time for the whole industry as such. You know, I know everyone says that there's a bit of a bounce back. But that bounce back is happening right at the end with the entertainment industry. Well, we've got two brand new faces with the most interesting film name. I mean, I didn't even know that was a film name until I actually saw it again. I said, okay. One of the best days of the week and two, Tuesday being like the middle of the week. That's actually the name of the film, Tuesdays and Fridays. Amol and Jatalika, thank you so much for joining me.
What's up?
Thank you. How are you?
Good afternoon.
Very good. Good afternoon. And before I ask you various questions, there's a bit of a surname also attached that we'll come to that too, which is going to be fun. How does it feel in the most, I would say, strangest year you have your debut and you come out there? So, Jatalika, we'll start with you. Since this is like the new world for you, at least as far as film is concerned, did you think that, yeah, 2020, then 21, and we're seeing this happening? Are you happy in this world that you come out?
I'm just happy that we're coming out. We've had a year of you know, not knowing what's going to happen and full of uncertainty, and that was definitely difficult because you know we had this film made and we were looking forward for it to release and for people to watch. And I know it's not the best time, and it's you know, it's not ideal, but I'm just grateful that we are getting a chance and opportunity to come out.
You know, it's actually a double-edged, not just a sword, but it could be an opportunity. Because not much else is coming out also, and everyone's sort of laying back. It happened, you know, years back with the IPL. I remember when the IPL came out, Imran Hashmi had come out with a film, you know, which was all about betting. And it was called, I forget the name of the film. But when it came out, nobody else used to come out during the IPL. And suddenly that film did really well. Jannat did superbly well. And suddenly they said, oh, this actually worked out very well. So you never know. This could be a blessing in disguise for you. You never know.
Keeping my fingers crossed.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Amol, what about you? This is going to be, well, how should I say this? You come from a legacy of a film background. At least you have like a film background attached to you. You have a Dilno surname. You know what the film industry at least is when you've heard about it. You're seeing it. But then suddenly when you're in it, everything becomes the other way around. You know, you've got people judging, people checking, people commenting. Has it been nerve-wracking for you?
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, to be honest with you, Salil, with me, at least I can speak for myself. I think I wasn't really in the public eye at all before this. I don't think people know of me prior to what, you know, they've probably seen in the trailer or the songs. So for me, it was slightly different because I wasn't plastered all over the place, you know. So a lot of people, I think now also when they're watching it, they're kind of just enjoying me for me. Yeah. And I'm glad that that's happening, that there are no real, you know, pointers that, you know, this, that they're actually enjoying this, the, you know, the trailer, the songs, both of us as characters and as individuals like that. So it's not really too much about the surname at this point, I think.
But for you yourself also, there will be the pressure, you know, it's almost like sometimes even though you could be unknown, like you said, for a short while until the film comes out.
Right.
And then you suddenly go like, you know, but everyone's expecting me to be really good. Yeah. Kyunki I better perform. So performance anxiety.
Yeah. See, the thing is, in my case, I got this film by auditioning for it a lot. Like I remember Mr. Bhansali at the time was meeting numerous young boys and girls, not just the two of us. So, it was like any other person's process in that sense. You know, I gave in my tapes, I gave in my dance videos, my acting tapes, all of that. And I kind of got it based on that. Yeah. So for me, I can just speak about my own journey. And it feels good that you audition for something and you earn it on merit. So it's always nice.
What have been the comments like that you've been reading? I mean, A, first of all, I have to say, Jatalika, I love your name. I know that, you know, it's going to be a point also that say, what a name. Because it sounds like a very strong name. I would have expected Jatalika to do Jhansi Ki Rani right up in the beginning, you know what I mean? But this is like a really sweet Tuesdays and Fridays. Did you think about that? Is that name going to work? I know that it talks about the plot of the film, but still.
I know. Yeah, well, Salil, a lot of people came out and, you know, told me that maybe you should consider changing your name. It's it's going to be mispronounced, and and we don't know if it's going to be taken well. And in fact, I have decided to go just with my name and not with my last name.
Okay.
It's because it's who I am. And I think I somewhere did always, although, you know, people made fun of it, even growing up in school, I experienced that. But I always had the sense of pride when it came to my name. And because it stands out. I mean,
For sure.
It stands out. And, you know, I felt that, you know, when I'm getting into the industry, why not stand out?
Yeah, and it's so unique. It's not the usual name that is there. But I have to thank you both because everyone calls me Sahil. They'll see Salil Riddle there. And Salil Ankola also calls me Sahil. I said, brother, aapka bhi to naam Salil hai. So thank you for at least calling me Salil.
I've watched so much of you before, so I'm very familiar with you, your face, your name. And your biceps also. Those guns, dude, it's all about those guns also.
You know, so when you age well, I guess this is all that you remember. That's why I keep half. This has helped me in that way, it's half. You don't have to show like the entire bit of it. So the film industry can be sometimes unnerving and daunting, you know. I know that you all have the luxury as of now to stay away, you know, because of the pandemic, not much going out there. If you had been a normal powerful course, you would have been out there with your city tours, meeting people, and you get a sense of it. And that's because I've done so much of that with so many artists. Isn't that a little sense of unnervingness to you all? Because you all can't meet the public to get the reaction. You can't really gauge what's happening there. So how have you been able to gauge how people have reacted to the trailer apart from comments? Lots of friends or what?
Yeah, we have like friends and their friends telling them and then they communicating it to us. And that's the only way that we're really going to know anything at this point in time. And of course, social media and, you know, comments have to say. But besides that, there's no real response or, you know, review of the trailer that I have been able to gather from an audience perspective.
What about the comments? Are you guys, because when the first ones come out, right, you're checking every article out there, you're scrolling down the comments, the nice ones, you go, you want to like take a screenshot, put it out on a story, and the not so nice ones, you're going, I want to delete this. So how have you dealt with the not so nice ones and the nice ones?
I think for me personally, I'm someone who's very like, I can take things neutrally. Like, you know, I don't take the good too seriously and the bad too seriously. I'm very like, I like to neutralize and balance. So for me, I'm like, dono hone wala, and you have to kind of take the bad with a pinch of salt and the good with a smile on your face and not too seriously also, you know? So it's interesting. I'm cool with the criticism and I'm
with the
happy
amount
with the
of
praise.
Trolling that we have these days, I think it's important that you be prepared beforehand.
Yeah.
No, but you know, when it hits you like a wave, it can still really, you just don't know how to, because you don't understand why people are doing that. I mean, what are they going to get out of just writing rubbish about it, man? So sometimes, we all get trolled so much on social media also and stuff like that. Yeah.
Culture of its own. Yeah, you know, it's like you have social media, which is going one way, and then you have trolling, which is going along with it.
Yeah, man,
I mean, haters going to hate. All we can do is be calm and meditate.
Well, the way I look at you, you look like a Buddha only. So now we'll talk about this. Jatalika, the two of you meeting the first time, lots of rehearsals or how was it? Was there like a, okay, you're with me, you better not mess this up. This is going to be our big break. So was it like that or how was it?
I think there was a lot of understanding because we knew each other before. We knew each other socially and we were from the same agency. So, you know, there was, there was acquaintance and there was also met each other.
We did,
So that did help. And we also had scene readings with our film director. And he, you know, tried to get us into the characters and explained to us what he needed from his characters. And
did he surprise you, but in the performance? Because sometimes from scene reading to actual performance out there, you know, they can, oh my God, I better up my game because he's really out there. Did he surprise you?
I still remember, I don't know if he remembers this, but on our first day of shoot, you know, we started shooting with a song which has just come out today. funky Mohabbat. And it was a night shoot, right? And I'm a morning person. So I was it's so difficult, Salil, to like stay up. And he's a night person. So I would, you know, keep running to him and he, I need to keep my eyes open. And that the first day we were coming at, I think we packed up at about 5 or 6 a.m. Mm. And I was in the car and I just looked at him and I'm like, man, this is different. Being on set is something else because, you know, those standby cameras and those. I couldn't understand what was happening. I was just like in the middle of this big set and like equipments all around me. And it was very different. It was. Yes.
You bet. From a scene reading in a room to a big set, of course, it's going to be different, man.
Fair enough. And I think most learning happens when you're on the floor and on the set, right? Every day of shoot, I think we both were still learning and gauging things because you can't prepare for it. When you're there, you think, ja ke nachna hai. But when you're there, there's so many people around you. You have to keep certain things in mind, their frames. Your hand can't go here. Your leg has to be here. You can't bump. You can't elbow someone. You know, there's so much going on that you really need to be. I think focus is something that's very underestimated. I think in terms of when you're an actor, I think you have to have immense concentration and focus. Yeah, I think that's the main thing.
Where did you think that you'd like, okay, now I'm comfortable. Both of you, like you're going, I need the focus. I need to do all this, but there's also responsibility. I can't let people down that I've put so much into this. So when did you feel a lot of people come with a lot of pressure? It's like a cricket match, right? When a brand new batsman comes out there, the first ball is tricky, but after about 20, 30 balls, you've got to start hitting your strokes, right? So when did you come into stride, both of y'all?
I think for me, it was right after we got done with both our songs, we shot our songs and then we got into the scene work and the first scene that we did together, I think that was it. I mean,
that was such a nice scene.
Yeah, that was such a nice scene also.
Because, I think we got thrown into the deep end, I would say, in these two big club songs to begin with. You know, people thought maybe, you know, gaane easier. But after those 4 or 5 days of those two songs, and as she said, when we went to our first scene, which was a really quiet, peaceful scene, which me and her are taking a walk and having a conversation in this lovely park in England. So there we suddenly felt more at ease, I think.
It felt normal because, you know, you were like, there weren't too many people. There wasn't this.
There wasn't chaos, basically. Like, you know, there wasn't chaos. There weren't like thumping music and sound. It was like this sweet romantic, like how you take a walk in the night with your person. Yeah. It was like that.
You know, actually, performances have changed over the years. And I think OTT has a lot to do with that, you know. I mean, there was a time, a long time back, you know, when we used to do television, the eyebrows were really big. And then, you know, you'd have those bits. But people like that. And then they shifted to different kinds. So even if you go back to watching Taal, you know, different style of acting. Now, I think a lot of people, if we'd done these kind of performances, then they would say, acting nahi ho raha hai, thoda acting karo camera ke samne, you know. A lot of that has changed. And I think that it's made actors more comfortable. So maybe, you know, you're not even performing, you know, you're just there and the scene is being shot. So is that why also, you know, a lot of people feel very comfortable? So maybe that's why your talky scenes must have felt very chilled out.
I think first, credit to our director. Second, credit to each other. Because I think we were so comfortable with each other that we just felt like, as you said, conversational. And I think our director wanted this, as it's a rom-com. It's a very real space. You want to just know what a boy and girl sound like, talk like, walk like when they're actually together on a date. So that's what we wanted to kind of get across.
Keep it more effortless because you're not really thinking when you're... I mean, if I were to... go out with him.
Yeah, of course.
I wouldn't be thinking that, oh my God, he made a line there. Like, you know, it's action reaction. Like,
but are you all improvising? A lot of the times when you're doing first films and all, you're going like, the script writer's looking, don't shaft me by not saying my lines. You know, a lot of that. So was there a lot of improv?
We had a lot of support from our director. And the one thing which
he's also the writer of the film. So
So like for me, especially because, you know, I get very like over enthusiastic when, you know, I have a script and I have to try different things. So he had this thing where like he would give us instructions as to how he wanted the scene to go about. And then he would give us one take, which he would call a take for love. And so he said, how you do it for love. And so we would do whatever we wanted to do or the way we perceived the scene. And I think that was great because it also helped give us confidence and, you know, as actors, because when we're new and we're beginners. For the director to show that much faith in us that, okay, I'm going to give you one take and you can do it the way you want to do it. You know, and it may just work. And sometimes it worked.
It did.
It just worked because the film as such, it's just about how you spend time together and how you create those moments. And
there was a lot of give and take, I think, with the director. And I think it's very important that everyone's kind of at least somewhere on the same page, right? Because if everyone's thought process and vision is similar, it's very easy to kind of follow a track. So I think credit to him that he spent that time with us and that we all kind of knew what we had to do. And yeah, for sure, if I'd add something in the end or, you know, do something spontaneous, and if he liked it, he'd be very open to keeping it. So it was a very...
Yeah, like Anmol always had these really quirky things that he would land up doing, you know, like actions. And so Taran would pick up like a few of them.
Yeah, he'd be like, cute. Yeah. Basically, if he said cute, it was his approval. That was his approval. Cute. Thoda aur cute. Thoda kam cute.
But I like this. The both of y'all are looking very cute. We take a little break and come right back. Don't go anywhere. Tuesday and Friday, not the day of the week. It's a film coming out. You know, whenever you think about a new film coming out, you're thinking, okay, cast, theater, large scale, new, songs. It's a bit different. We're in a different world. But, you know, when it does come out, what's going to happen is the one thing that the both of you are actually going to be saved from is that while you're watching a film, the critics who start writing their reviews. Mujhe ye achha nahi laga, mujhe wo achha nahi laga. So congratulations on that. That's the most unnerving thing because it's not going to happen. You know, and that actually can break the confidence of so many actors that come out there. So, yeah, but we're going to do it right now with you. Jatalika, three things about him that you don't like and you want him to change as a person on the set. No rapid fires here, just simple. You need to change some three things.
He's very not superstitious, but like very anal about things. So like, you know, things like in particular about falling sick. So he has this phobia when it comes to mosquitoes and like, you know, and he'll have his bat all over the place.
Really? Tumhara history, you have a history of this or what? You have a history of this or what?
No, I just think I like to be careful and not, because I'm very scared of like the hospital and injections and all. So I just want to stay away from that as much as I can.
I don't even want to know how you handle this 1 year of corona.
That's what I'm saying. That's what, like, where's my mask? It's somewhere here only. Even like, I was feeling scared, you know. I was like, listen, you're being good now.
Okay, number two.
Number two would be, I'm kind of envious of his metabolism. He has a great metabolism and so he can eat anything. And he would be, you know, eating these burgers and fried chicken things in front of me. And I'd be like, oh,
wow.
But apparently I'd shoot. What are you doing? And yeah, it wouldn't show on him at all.
Wow.
Second thing is that. Third thing, he takes a lot of time to get ready and get out. You know, to take that first step out. It's like, Anmol, yeah, I'm coming. And then he, like, you know, changing his sunglasses. Like, I don't know how many times. Is that? So, yeah.
You get a shot, Anmol. You get a shot. Jatalika needs to change. What about her?
Jatalika changed. Well, A, that she used to always beat me at waking up. I think that was easier for her. So that was something I kind of learned from her, because I tend to listen to like songs while showering. So sometimes I end up dancing too much in the shower. So sometimes she would already be down eating her breakfast. I'm like, dude, why couldn't you just time it with me? So I think that would be one. I think two, the fact that she has such a lovely smile. So I'm like, yeah, don't have a nice smile. So don't overshine me too much. So just that little bit. I think we both have decent.
How sweet, man. You aren't being mean at all. She really came out with guns blazing. And you're like, oh, she needs to change her smile. Okay, but you know, as performers also, you all have seen each other. And you know, could be the first movie you all do together. Maybe you all do more together or, you know, later on. But you know, the one thing that you really liked about him that you'd want to tell the whole world, you know, as a performer, that you liked about him?
This is something that I've always told him also, that our industry at the moment is missing that rom-com space and a rom-com hero. And yeah. I think, you know, Anmol naturally has this thing where he fits in just right in that whole, oh, I'm going to fall in love with you space. You know, it's very, the relatable space, not the macho space, the very like, how sweet. And how, like you said, you can't be mean. He's just that. Like, how sweet. Oh my God, I'm just going to fall in love.
She's recovered well, huh? She's recovered well, Anmol. She's, yeah. And about her, what do you have to say? You have to put it out there.
She's like, I'm one who's always like, you know, with my lines, like constantly, they're like, just leave the paper, yeah, it's fine. Because I'm like over-preparing. I think she has this ability to just, you know, kind of read it and get into the ease and flow of things and, you know, just come and surprise you, I think, on set, which is great. So I want to learn that from her. You know, it's like, I don't want to just, you know, I think sometimes over-preparing is also not yeah. great. You know, so I just, so that quality about her is great, I think, as a performer. And that's what I saw on set a lot, yeah.
You all have seen the film now. Are you all happy with, you know, a performer knows if he's nailed it. You know that, you know, sometimes a lot of people don't like watching them on screen, ourselves on screen, you know. So it used to happen when we used to do television or this, that. You just want somebody else to come and say, oh, you've done a good job. But now that you all have watched each other, do you all think you need to change anything about yourself or you're very happy with what you did? You have to be honest.
We haven't seen the film. We haven't seen.
Oh.
Yeah.
Really?
Really seen the film. So we've seen whatever. Like, yeah, during dubbing we saw. So it was, I think first it was just so strange, right? To see yourself and hear yourself, see yourself walk, talk. So I think initially to disconnect from that is a little hard.
Yeah.
And then there's certain things you're like, hey, I like that. And then certain things you're like, I don't like that. So I think it's a bit of both. Yeah. I think we're
I
so
think the
new.
Only thing that we both were like pleasantly surprised with was that, you know, when we went for dubbing, we're like, okay, we sound fine.
Yeah, we don't have those annoying voices.
Dance, right? We're like, oh my God, I don't know how my voice is going to sound. So I was like, thank God for that.
Don't worry, that can be taken care of very easily technically. Yeah. That really works with you all.
What we also got to hear, I think, from a lot of people who are seeing stuff on set through dubbing is that we have good chemistry. I think that's very important initially and especially for a love story. That the boy and girl look good together and they vibe and have a good energy on screen.
For
so
it
I
to
think,
be believable.
I yeah, I think that's a great plus for us. So that's something we're banking on as well, I think, with this.
You all are very chilled, man. I've seen a lot of, you know, people making their debut that can get very hyper, that want to conquer the world. I've had artists come say that, I can't wait to see this because I've signed another 10 films and I can't wait to show my wares to the world. You know, and it's you sometimes realize that you've got to be a little less aggressive. I love the laid-back, chilled-out attitude that you guys have. And that's going for you all. Tuesday and Friday, it's such a unique name is going to work for you all. Or not work. So we'll hope that it'll work completely.
Salil, please just mention to them that it's available the whole week and weekends. I'm not only on Friday. They shouldn't think that we're going to go to cinema only two days.
He's mentioned it. But of course, Tuesday and Fridays is when they meet in the film. And then they work out what they do on the rest of the days. Aapko trailer dekh ke samajh mein aa jayega. And if you haven't watched the trailer, then I can't help you. You have to go watch the trailer, okay? So it's called Tuesdays and Fridays, guys. Good luck and stay as chilled as this. And don't let any negativity come into y'all. Because remember, I just have one word of advice. Those that keep trolling and are negative are just jealous, man. It's pure jealousy that they can't be where y'all are. And so just take that. And whenever somebody gets really like hardcore, you'll say, मैं तुम्हें नेक्स्ट फिल्म में मेरा साइड असिस्टेंट का रोल दे दूंगा
दैट्स हार्श बट थैंक यू सलील फॉर स्पीकिंग विद अस थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम
थैंक्स मैन रियल प्लेजर एंड होप आई सी यू गाइस सून इनफ मे बी इन द नेक्स्ट फिल्म वी विल प्रोबब्ली बी इन पर्सन मैन
यस ऑलराइट थैंक्स डूड बाय
थैंक यू